guys, it's Lauren. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new here. And if you are new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. I mean, you know the whole spiel, but I don't want you missing any more of my videos. So today I'm really excited because I'm going to be talking about questions that you guys gave me about my hair extensions. As you can probably tell, I do not have any in right now. I want to show you guys my natural hair. I actually just got an inch and a half cut off, so it's a little shorter than usual. But I'm going to be showing you guys what extensions I use and answering questions, so make sure to keep watching. This is my first time using my ring light, and it is blinding, let me tell you. Okay, also sorry if there's like weird shadows in the back. I'm still trying to figure out the best way to do everything. So someone asked me, what length are they and how do you blend them so perfectly? Seriously, your hair is flawless. Thanks, Vila. I have two different lengths. I have a 24 inch, which is right here. These are so long, but I love them. They're perfect for braids. And whenever you see me with really long braids, like in the back or on the side, this is probably what I'm wearing. These are from Bella Me, and the other brand I have is Luxie Hair. I love them both equally. I honestly don't think I could even choose which one I love better, but the Luxie Hair ones I have are the 20 inch. These are the 20 inch, as you can see right now, they're curled, but this is what I usually wear if you see me with my hair down. 20 inch is nice because it blends better with my hair and it just looks better down, I think. I think the length looks more natural, but I love, love, love these for hairstyles. So those are the two lengths that I have, and this is Luxie Hair and Bella Me. Another question I got, which is one that I get all the time, is do they ever bother you or look unnatural? And the answer is kind of yes and no to both. They can be bothersome if you don't put them in right. Sometimes I clip something and it like feels weird, so I just have to readjust it. But honestly, you get really used to it, and I don't sleep in them or anything. I have accidentally slept in them before, and don't do that. But yeah, I mean, other than that, they never really bother me that much. They're pretty comfortable. They feel like my natural hair. And do they ever look unnatural? Yes, they can if you don't blend them well. Or like right now, it has been winter and my hair is getting so dark, so I need to re-dye them. So my extensions are a little light for my hair. But if you find the right color, the right length, everything will work out. I also get questions about how I braid my hair. There was this one braid that I was doing that was just like a ponytail with a loose fishtail. So I'm going to be doing a Valentine's Day like hair lookbook tutorial thing, and I will show you guys how to do that one and any others that you guys have questions about. Another commonly asked question is, how long does your hair need to be to have extensions? And honestly, there's no like specific length. Your hair can be literally to your shoulders. It doesn't matter. I think what matters is how long your extensions are compared to your hair. So if you have pretty short hair, I recommend going with the shortest length so that you can cut them, or it'll just look the most natural. Another question is, what kind of hair extensions should you get? And always get real hair. This is so important. You don't want to get the gross like plasticky hair, because then you can't curl it and straighten it and it won't last as long. So make sure you go to sites, I'll link the two I got mine from below, that have real human hair. Can you color hair extensions? Yes, you can. You definitely have to find a certain place that would do it. I don't get mine colored just because they match, but you have to go darker. It's not recommended that you go lighter because it damages the hair extensions more, but you can dye them if you need to. What products do you use on hair extensions? I'm actually going to show you guys pretty soon how I wash them in this video. And I only use some like chi silk infusion or like Moroccan oil on the ends after I wash them, and that's it. I don't put any hairspray, and I don't even put a heat protector on them, because the more product you have on, the more buildup you have, and you have to wash them more often and they get dried out faster. So I don't put any product. I kind of already went over this, but can you sleep in your hair extensions? And also another question that's common is, can you swim in them? No, I would not sleep in them. You can if you want. You can also work out in them if you want. I know that's another question some people ask. I just don't recommend it, because you might as well just throw your regular hair up in a bun or something. And then can you swim in them? I personally wouldn't submerge myself underwater, but if you're just having like a day at the beach, like in the waves, like yeah, I think it's totally fine. How do you store your hair extensions? I wish I had some like great plan for how I store mine, and they're all organized and they look really nice. But to be honest, I am so bad at taking care of my hair extensions. extensions, I usually take them out at the end of the day and literally just like lay them on my desk, which I guess isn't that bad because they're just laying flat. So if you don't care if you have your hair extensions out all the time, that's fine. The other day, maintenance came in and I was on the phone with my mom, and after they left, I was like, "Mom, my hair extensions were out on my coffee table," and the maintenance guy was probably like, "What the heck is this girl doing?" But I know a lot of people like to keep the nets that they come in and twist them up like this and just put your hair extensions back in the net. I know that's really good for them. The better you store them, the longer they'll last, so that's something to definitely think about. I don't know how people go years and years with the same hair extensions. I've been getting hair extensions or buying clip-in ones since 8th grade, and mine never last more than maybe like 5-6 months, which is actually a long time, especially because I wear mine all the time, but definitely try to take care of yours better than I do. Can you put heat on your hair extensions? Yes, if you get the right kind. Mine, you can put any kind of heat on it that you want, except for blow drying. That's super important. I blow dry mine because I needed to do a blog post, and they are so, I need to buy a new pair of Lexis. How do you put in your hair extensions? This is one that I got asked on my blog, and I want to do a full video on how I do them for when my hair is just down, for how I do them when my hair is in braids, and then how I do it when my hair is in a ponytail. So if you guys are interested in that, give this video a thumbs up. That's kind of all I'm seeing for questions. I know another one is, how long does it take for hair extensions to ship? I know when I bought hair extensions in 8th grade, it literally took like 4 weeks, but I got both of these hair extensions in like less than a week, which was awesome. So you can honestly order them now and then have them for whatever occasion you need to. And yeah. So the last thing I want to answer is how I wash my hair extensions. So let's just get on into that. So here is how I wash my hair extensions. The first thing you want to do is comb through your extensions and get all the tangles out. I use a wet brush. I love the wet brush, even on my natural hair. As you can see, my dog got to it. Don't worry, he didn't actually eat any of the little bristle things off of it. He just likes destroying things sometimes, but yeah, I need a new one. I like to wash my extensions by weft size, so I put all the 1 and 2 clip wefts together, and the 3 clip wefts, and the 4 clip wefts. That's kind of a tongue twister. My secret weapon for washing hair extensions is using clip hangers. I actually found this tip when I was in 8th grade, and I've been doing it ever since. They are lifesavers. They make it easy to dry and just to hang up while you wash them. I shampoo my extensions with normal shampoo, like anything that you could buy at Target, but I am definitely way more gentle when it comes to my extensions. As you can see, I just kind of lightly rub my hands over the extensions, careful not to tangle them or pull too hard. Then I thoroughly rinse them out. Next is time for conditioner. I condition my extensions the same way I do my real hair, which is by letting them sit for a while. I usually put the conditioner on them and let them sit for about 10 to 15 minutes. Then again, thoroughly rinse them out, because if you don't, they feel all like gummy the next day, and it's not what you want. Which, by the way, I didn't really say this at the beginning, but it's best to wash your hair extensions the night before you want to wear them, because if you don't, they will take forever to dry and you'll have to use a hair dryer and it'll be bad. When I'm done, I squeeze the water out with a towel and add in whatever moisturizing product I'm using at the moment. Right now I'm using my Chi Silk Infusion that I've had forever because I ran out of my Moroccan oil, but I really like it and it made my extensions really soft. So that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this little clip and hair extension Q&A, and I hope it was helpful, and I hope it made you want to buy hair extensions because I love mine. I'll insert some photos of me wearing mine right here just in case you are new here and don't know what my hair looks like with it. I love them. I think they look so natural and so fun to play around with your hair with different lengths. So thanks again for watching. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe down below, and I will see y'all next time. Bye.